Friends, here we are going to write one simple Python script. The purpose of your Python script is find all files in a directory with extension .py or .sh or maybe any your required extension. I mean, while running your Python script, first of all, it has to ask enter your directory path. After giving your path, it has to ask enter the extension of your required files. Suppose let's say I'm giving .py extension. Then it has to display only .py files in the given location. Suppose if I give .sh, then it has to display only .ssh files in the given location. Right? Let me go and write my script. So as of now, I'm going to open my Unix box. Same script will run even on your Windows as well. Right? See that. Let me take some simple script as get required extension files.py. See, this is shebang. Sorry, this is Unix like systems. You can also write your shebang line. So this is my Python location, but don't write this whenever if you are running your script on your Windows systems. It will work only on your Unix like systems. Okay, now the first thing is our script has to read a path. Path is always a string. We know in Python 3 to read your path, we have, let me take user path or required path. I'm taking required path, right? Input, enter your path, enter your directory path. That's it. Then after giving your directory path, immediately you have to ask to the user required extension. Now in that given location, what are the files you need with what extension you need, right? That's why enter the required files extension. Example, I'm giving .py or .sh, .log, maybe anything based on user requirement, maybe .txt, whatever it may be. That's what I want to read from the user. Fine. So first of all, user is okay. As of now, you are going to run this script. See the how it is going to work. Let me take some path. This as my path, suppose. Let me come out from here. Then I'm going to run our Python script. Before going to run, let me provide execution permissions. Now, because this is Linux system, after providing your permissions, after giving your shebang line, you can run your Python script with .slash. So it is asking enter your directory path. Now I'm entering suppose this one. Any path, your required path you can give. After that it is asking enter your required extension for your files. I am entering suppose .py. Your script is ending because as of now you don't have any logic to find out your extensions, your files with extension. Only we have a logic to read path and then to read your extension of a file. Fine. See, suppose given path by mistake, suppose if user enters a file path, right? See, suppose if I take this as a path, this is directory path, suppose. Now if I take suppose something like we don't have anything here. Yeah, get required this. If I give this one, right, this is not a directory. If it is not a directory, you don't have anything inside of that, right? So that's why this path is always a directory. So what I want to do is after reading your directory path, I am checking whether this is a valid directory path or not. So it's a good practice actually to write that logic. So before reading your extension, right, I can also write my logic after reading extension, but before reading extension, I am writing my logic. That is, if given path is file or directory, I want to check it. You know, in your Python, you have a OS module. In that OS module, we know we have os.path.isfile or is directory. So now what I'm checking is os.path.isfile. If it is a file, I want to stop my script. And then I want to say the user, please pass only directory path. Okay. So guys, this script I'm implementing just to give ideas about your modules and some concepts. Okay. You may write the same code in a different way. No problem. Fine. Now what I am doing is, in case if the given path is a file, then what I want to say to the user, print the given path, whatever the user is going to give, the given path, that path, required path is a file. Please pass only directory path. That's it. I'm closing. Then else, right? So here I need to write my logic. So for time being, I will write this also so that you will get some ideas. I'm writing here. Now let me remove this path here. So here I need to implement my logic. As of now, I am not implementing. We'll come back and we'll implement. Okay. So implement your actual logic here. We'll implement it after some time. Just wait. Now let me save it. Right. So what I am doing is, let me do one thing under Udemy. Let me take some read I will do one thing. Okay, come back, and this is your script, right? Now I'm running that. So it is asking enter your directory path, but suppose, just assume that I'm going to give a path called, in this location, I'm going to give some files path. Let's say it may be anything. Then script is saying that, see that, enter required. Okay, required file extension. Let me enter .py. The given path is a file. Please pass only directory path. Suppose if I enter only directory path, let me take this one. Now your script display. Implement your actual logic. We need to implement that part. Right? Now, see one more thing. Here we are going to implement our logic. Okay, first of all, what I will do is, I will list all your directories and files in the given location. See, in else block only, because in if condition, what we are checking, if it is a file, then we are displaying this information. You know, if this is true, then your else block won't execute. If this is false, means you are giving valid directory path. Then you're going to execute this one. Right? Now see what I am doing is, print. See, in the given location, if you want to list all your directories and files, if you remember, there is a operation called os.listDirectory, then your required path. Okay, let me save it and run it and see the result. I'm running, and I'm going to provide your path as directory path. Okay, let me provide extension .py. Yes, in the given location, you are getting all the files which are there. But actually, our intention is, we have to display only to suppose .py or .sh, whatever it may be, whatever the user is going to enter, that extension files we need to identify. So now what I have to do, I have to take one by one file from here, and I need to check it whether it is ending with .py or not. You know how to take one by one file from a list. By using for loop, you can take it. But before that, let me tell you one more thing. See, whatever the path you are going to enter, if it is empty, then why should we check whether file is ending with .py or not? Right? So that's why what I am doing is, before writing your actual logic, I am checking. First, let me find out all files and directories. All files and directories in the given location. Then after that, I am writing one more if condition inside of your else. That is, if length of, you know, what is the length function? It is going to find out number of values in the given list. You know, this operation output is a list, guys. Now I am checking how many values are there in this. By mistake, if you have a zero values, means there are no files and directories in the given location. So at that time, I don't need to find any logic, right? So I am writing simply print the given path is an empty path. So that path I am writing here. What is the given path? Required path. That's it. let me check it whether it is working perfectly or not. Else, then we have to write actual logic. So then else, here I'm going to write print implement your logic. So as of now, we are not implementing. Yes, we'll implement it, right? Just wait. Now, there is a directory called empty. I'm taking this empty directory. And then let me take this one and also that path, then come back. Then we have our file here. Let me run it. Oh man, one extra parenthesis. Let me remove that. See that directory path, I'm going to in this remove this parenthesis. That's it. Right? Fine. Now I'm running this one. See the output? Enter your directory path. I'm entering suppose Udemy path. Now see the output. Okay, enter the required files extension as well. Let me enter it. Implement your logic. Actually, this is not an empty directory, right? That's why implement your logic. Now what I am doing is I am going to enter empty directory path now. Now see the result. The given path is whatever the path, an empty path, right? That's why no need to find .py files. But if you observe your logic clearly, let me open it first. Before checking whether the given path is empty or not, you are also reading required file extension. Now, in case if a given path is an empty path, why should we read this extension, guys? That's why now what I am doing is I am going to comment the line, or I am going to remove that line there, and I want to write somewhere else. Where I have to write? If your given path is having some files, then only I want to read extension. Right? See, if else block is executing means inside of your else, you have one more if else. If this else is executing means you have some list of files in the given location, then only I want to read an extension. Right? Now see, let me save it and run it. And before going to run, let me take my path, this one. Now I am providing empty path. Now directly it is giving given path is an empty path. Now if I give some valid path, I mean a path which is having some values, now it will also ask enter your extension, right? If you give empty path, it is not asking. If it give some path which is having some values, some files and directories, then only it is asking enter your extension. That's good actually. So unnecessarily we are not going to read extension if your given path is an empty. Fine. Now what I am doing is after reading your extension, our requirement is we have to take one by one file from all your files and directories. So I am taking for each file in your list of files. Let me first print each file in the given location. Right? Let me run it. /. I am going to run. It is asking enter your path. Let me enter my path as suppose this one. Yes. Now I am giving extension as .py. But your script is printing all the files, right? Files and directories. I don't want to print all the files which are ending with .py, those files only I want to print. That's why again in your if condition, sorry, again in your for loop, you have to add a if condition before printing your files. See what I am doing? Before printing your file, if you remember, string operation is there, that is ends with. Your path is always string. Now file is a string, directory is a string. Now simply I'm doing, is it ending with .py extension? If it is really ending with .py extension, then only I want to print. Otherwise I don't bother about that. Right? Now let me run your script and see the result. Now I am giving path as, and I am giving .py. See the output, you are getting only .py files. Now let me run your script once again and let me provide extension as suppose .sh. See the output? Oh man. Oh, the problem is directly I fixed extension is .py. But whatever the path extension you are reading, that variable you have to write now. So actually this in this you are storing your extension, right? Now it will work. Let me enter your path first. Let me enter .sh. Yes, you are getting only .ssh files. Let me rerun and provide suppose .py. Now you're getting only .py files, right? Fine. And if you observe your script is displaying individually your required files, but I don't want to print individually. I want to print all your .py or .sh as a list. Then how you can do it, right? See guys, whenever if you want to create a list based on your required values, first of all, you have to define somewhere an empty list. So after reading your extension, what I am doing is I am defining an empty list. That is, let me take required files equals to an empty list. Instead of printing, what I am doing is inside of your for loop, I am appending your each and every file into your list. If you remember, there is an append operation with your list. The purpose of append operation is adding your given values to your list. That's it, right? And then after completion of your for loop, I am going to print finally the required, see the result, the required files are as a list I am printing. You have taken required files req, right? And I did a mistake in your loop. Let me go and modify that variable name as req, right? Fine. Let me save it and run it. I'm running. I'm going to provide a path called, where is my path? You can take any path, right? As of now, I'm giving this path and I'm giving .py extension. See the result. Now, instead of printing your files separately, you are getting as a list of your required files. Not only this, same script will work for any type of files. Let me enter and see the result. I'm entering suppose .sh. Yes, fine. Guys, now final concept is I'm giving a path called this one. Suppose I want to get a list of some batch files. See the result. The required files are empty list you are getting because there are no empty bat files in my given this directory. See the result here. We don't have anything which is ending with .bat. If I don't find any files ending with .bat in the given location, I don't want to print in this way. I want to print like there are no .bat files in the given location instead of printing an empty. Nothing is there. It's very simple. See that what I am doing is before printing your required files from this list, I am checking whether that is having zero values or not. Length of your required files, if it is equals to zero, then I want to print there are no, whatever the extension you are providing, that extension files in the location, in the location of, you can write your message in any way. No, what is the your required given path? This one, right? That's it. Else then only, else means not equals to zero means there are some files. Now I am printing that, right? See the result. Now I'm going to run your script. Let me copy your path. I'm giving your path extension I am giving dot bat. There are no dot bat files in the location of your that one. Let me rerun and provide dot py extensions. Yes, you are getting right, but one more just for your decoration purpose. I want to write one more line. That is, if you have some values, if you have some dot py files, how many files you have in that, right? See, nothing is there. Again, it's very simple. I'm printing with one more print statement, print there are length of your required files. That means it is going to give a count how many values are there in that list. There are in this many number of files in the location of required path with an extension of whatever the given extension, right? That is there in this. That's it. Fine. And they are now, instead of writing the required files are, I can write, so the files are, so the files are, that's it. Let me save it and run it. I'm giving a path of this one. Now see the magic. Dot py. There are five files in the location of with an extension dot py. Then so the files are, you are getting those five files. Not only this, right? You can provide any path and any file extension automatically. Now our Python script will fetch them. Only two files and you are getting them, right? So guys, this is the simple way to get your required files with your required extension in the given location. See here, maybe concepts are simple, but the thing is, you have to understand that why we are taking first if else block and why we are writing the code only inside of your else block of your first if condition. First, this is our main code, guys. If you want to understand this code, you have to understand in this way. If you run your code, it will execute from top to down, right? You have three lines, one, two, three, four, five main lines. In the five main lines, whenever if you run your script, so by this line, your operating system will understand that the remaining code has to run with the help of your Python 3. Then you are importing OS, then you are reading your path, then you commented this, don't worry about this line. Then if and else. So first of all, you have to understand that if condition is true, this line will execute. If condition is false, this entire block is going to execute. But inside that, again, we have one more condition. That's a different story. If given path is a file, then you are going to execute this line. Then you don't have any lines to execute. If this is false, means given path is directory, right? Then you are going to execute these lines, right? Then you are finding the number of files and directories which are there in the given path, right? Then maybe you have some files and directories in the given location, or you may not have anything in that. That's why I'm checking if all files and directories in the given location, the number of values, if it equals to zero, no need to find the extension files, right? That's why if and else. If number of values, number of files and directories are equals to zero, then you are printing this one, then your script is over. If it is not equals to zero, means there are something, maybe files or directories or both, no problem. So if there are something, then only I want to read extension. Yes, I am reading that. Right? So this is just variable. You are defining an empty list. Then you are going to get some number of files and directories in this, right? Now my intention is I want to take one by one and then I want to check whether this is ending with your required extension or not. If it is ending with the required extension, then I am storing that value into this list. You know, in list you can store any number of values, right? After completion of your for loop, what I am doing, right? If length of your required files, whatever the files you are finding, if it is equals to zero, means there are no dot py or dot sh, whatever it may be, your extension. With that extension, you don't have any files. That's why I'm printing this information. Else means you have some files. Then I'm printing that. How many files are there and what are those? That's it. And guys, in this entire program, if you provide valid path, then only it will work. Suppose if you enter an invalid path, see that first of all, I'm entering now path as something. See that? No such file or directory. Right? That's why you have to provide valid file. In case if you provide invalid file or invalid path, then how to take care? We will see that while going forward. As of now, while running this script, you have to provide valid path only. It may be directory path or file path. If you provide file path, then your script will stop and says that this is a file path. Please pass only directory path. If you provide valid directory path, then it will work on your given path. Right? So if you provide any invalid path, how to handle? We will see that while going forward. I don't want to confuse you in a single video with all those concepts. Right? Fine. Okay, guys. Thank you for watching this video.